Hello, you guys, and welcome back to another Vivian Tries. On this Vivian Tries, I have for you another as seen on television product.
Your pet leaves fur wherever he goes, and it's impossible to clean when it gets on your clothes.
Today, we are trying the Fur Wizard by our favorite people over at Bulbhead.
Introducing the Hurricane Fur Wizard, an all-new extra-large lint brush that picks up fur and lint with ease.
This thing has been around for quite some time now, and it's still on the market, and people still request it a lot. So I thought, let's give it a try.
Fur Wizard is faster because of the double-sided action. It cleans up twice as much in half the time of other lint brushes.
The cool thing about this one, based on the infomercial, is that it comes with like a cleaning base so that you can just stick it in, pull it out, and here we go. The sharp left turns have begun.
Cleans up instantly with a self-cleaning base.
A base that actually cleans the lint off the brush so that you're not having to use like the traditional lint brush where you have to like throw away a lot of the roller paper thing.
You try tape rollers to clean your seat, but to get it all off, you need sheet after sheet.
Easy as 1, 2, 3, go. They forgot the go because if they put it on, they'd have to pay me royalties. Dip into the base, remove fur from the brush. No refills, no tape, no mess. Yes.
And the self-cleaning base uses its own micro-bristles to brush Fur Wizard clean.
For $19.99, this is a pretty good little package. You get the full size and the little baby one for your purse. So far, if it works, I think it's worth $19.99. This is the perfect price point, right? We like everything at $19.99. It is great for furniture, clothing, carpet, linens.
Tidying up your car seats becomes a breeze.
Pillows, and more. Ooh. Vivian, why do you have your favorite sweater up on here? I got so many questions about this sweater. I actually got this at Target in the little boy section. I know that's so weird. I got it in extra large, and as you guys saw, it fit perfect. The reason I brought it up for this video is because it's black, and I need to put some of Jedi's hair on there. That's so gross. This part might be gross for some people because they're like, ew, hair. I know, but how am I gonna demonstrate if I don't have any hair? I needed to, he was fluffy anyway. We needed to trim him a little bit, so I did. I'm gonna spread it around, and then we're gonna lint the hell out of it. Lint it, is that what we call it? I don't know, brush it. I don't know what it's called, but the action of removing the lint or fur from a shirt. What is the technical term for that? Okay. Ew. Wait, Bulbhead. Hey, pretty nice. Look how little that is. They ruined the bag with the infamous logo. I'm gonna turn that shit around. I'm gonna tape it. How about that? Oh, it's really nice. It feels really nice. Why am I smelling it? Ooh, it smells new. There shouldn't be instructions, right? It's a freaking brush. Here's our manual. One page is all that is needed. Do not run through water to clean the brush. Okay, so don't run it underwater. It's probably gonna get moldy and yuck. Do not use directly on pets. They're reminding you there's an arrow on here for a reason. So you have to use it like this. If you do this, it's not gonna work. Okay, that's what the arrows are there for. So you know what direction. Ah, in the infomercial they brag about the gazillion little fingers on this thing that pick up all the lint and hair.
The secret is the thousands of micro bristles that act like fingers grabbing every last piece of fur or fuzz.
Travel size brush is non-removable. Simply extend fully. What? What do you mean? No. I needed to come out. This to detach. What the hell you? I mean, if it works, I guess there's the arrow, but this is stupid. Like, somebody in the design department, please let me know why these don't come apart. Kind of silly, but if it works, attach them. I don't give a damn. When this case is full, you can take off the bottom to dump out all the junk.
Just remove the base clip to empty.
That's what it looks like on the inside. So far, easy, straightforward, worth the value. It feels nice. I mean, it's plasticky, but it's not like cheapy. The brush, cheapy. The brush feels really nice. There is a lot of dog hair on me. That is so gross. I hope the hell you don't walk around looking like this. If you do, let me know in the comments down below. We're gonna set up a GoFundMe account, raise you $19.95 so you can get one of these, because walking around looking like this is not acceptable. That's not a cute look. You're never gonna be able to close that Tinder account if you have this amount of dog hair on you.
With just one dip, both sides are cleaned up quick.
Let's see how this works really quick. So you're gonna put it in, take it. Oh, that's hard. I didn't expect that to. Whoa, you need to have some strength, boys and girls. Okay, in the infomercial, they made this shit look really easy, like
back into the face to clean the face, and it's ready again.
Like butter. It's not like butter. What? When I rip off the sheets off the sticky tape, it's quick, like butter. Let's see, if I just have it on the table, look at this. Ugh. Okay, you're definitely gonna have to have upper body strength. Look at this. I'm literally like gonna knock myself out. This one's not hard because it's little. And then you take the bottom off to take the stuff out. And then you pop it out of here, and then it's... I love the size of this thing. It is tiny. It will fit in your purse or in your suitcase if you're traveling with it. If you have some kind of hand problems, like muscle problems or arthritis or something, I don't know about this. This is like, you need some strength to pull this thing out of there. Okay, ready? I think I'm gonna have to hold it here. I think it's doing pretty good. It's grabbing all the junk off of it for sure. Now let's do the other side with this thing. Both sides of the sweater look pretty similar as far as dog hair is concerned. So far I'm impressed. I'm not impressed with this thing, but let's see how much of this it's really gonna take off of here. Okay. Ugh. Dude. Oh, it cleaned it. Is it in there? Yeah. I'm gonna try it again. Okay, I'm gonna do my shirt. I was gonna say my boob, but it's really a shirt. The boob is inside the shirt. I wanna do upward motion.
Clean the lint off your pants with ease.
Down. Okay, it got it all off of me, but the arrow is very important, because if you go the opposite direction of the arrow, you're just gonna throw that shit right back on you. So used to rolling, you know, I wanna do the up and down. You can't. So it's getting the majority of the hair off. There is still a little bit of dog hair on me when I'm using it in the right direction. Using it in the right direction, like the arrows are showing, is kind of a little bit of a pain in the ass. I wonder if this gets any easier with time. You know, is it hard because it's new? Or is it gonna be nice and tight forever? Okay, let's see. Okay, yeah, it definitely is picking up the dog hair, okay? And it picked it up here. So let's move on to the next fabric. As you can see, the beautiful fur. Here's our little arrow. So it's telling us to go downward. One, two, three, go. Oh, it's kind of hard.
Again, as Bird Wizard quickly and easily gets the mess left behind from shedding pets.
In this section, not so well. You're really gonna have to do some work. It's not getting all of the hair off. Like, if the hair is like in there real good, and it's probably picking up about 85% of the dog hair, but there's definitely still some hair on there. Let's clean it to see if it does better. Okay. It's still not getting all the dog hair. Okay, so I'm gonna say the roller is probably getting about 90% of the hair off, compared to this thing that got about 85% of the hair off. I mean, they're both sort of working, but they're not like amazing like the infomercial. Here we have another black shirt. Ooh, maybe I'll use the little one for this, right? I hate that it's attached, so I'm gonna try it like this, and I'm gonna try it by taking it apart. Let's take it apart. I'm gonna have to use it like this if I ever travel with it. Let's try it like this. The more I use it, the less impressed I am with it. The little one is not picking much up. Okay, I'm gonna put it back in here because you know somebody's gonna say, it's because you took it out of the casing. It's not. Let's try it like this. Let's clean it off. This is in the way of this little surface making contact with my shirt. So it's not like flat on there. You see what I'm saying? Look, this stupid casing, there's a gap there. Bad design. You gotta make this come out. You gotta detach these two in order for this to work. The little one doesn't work. I'm not liking it now. It is not picking up the hair that is like in there really good. Now we have a pair of my pants. They're made out of, I think, 60% wool. There's a lot of dog hair on there. This shit better come off. Okay, it's clean. 1, 2, 3, go. It's definitely picking up the hair, but is definitely leaving hair. Both. The pants had a lot more hair, and trying to take it off now, okay taking off, but I can still see hair kind of like clinching onto this thing because of the static. Let's try the other direction. I kind of hate it and I kind of love it all at the same time. Let's go try it on the couch. This is the before of Jedi's hair. Okay.
Just a few swipes of Fur Wizard easily cleans the entire surface.
Okay, you see it picked it up there.
No refills are ever needed. Use it over and over again.
Now let's go in the opposite direction. So there's the hair. This piece here came off. Maybe I was pulling it out too hard. I don't know, but that thing came off. Like a little crazy glue would have fixed that shit real quick. I don't understand why it has to come apart. Even if you have to wash, no, they said don't wash it. So why not just glue that shit with a little crazy glue, right? Static is like pulling all that hair to the tip here. So I imagine that if you shouldn't be that nasty. Let's pretend your hair or lint was about to hear. That means that is going to be about to hear on your fur brush. So even though you're cleaning it, it's sticking to about that much because of the static in the hair. This little bottom piece is just collecting all the shit at the bottom. If you're going to completely clean it out every single time, that's fine. I have not collected that much hair and it's already sticking to the bottom. Let's clean it off again. Here's the problem with it. It does pick up the hair, but once you go to clean it, and then with the static, and then with the wrong direction, you're gonna have a damn mess. You're gonna feel like it's a vicious circle that never ends of you cleaning it, then it stuck at the tip, and then you accidentally went the wrong direction. There's a learning curve, unfortunately, with this one. The moment that the hair starts to collect in there, you're gonna have issues because the tip is gonna be hairy. What? No tip should be hairy, you know? Oh, gotta see a doctor about that.
Just remove the base clip to empty.
There is all of Jedi's hair. Do you see what I'm saying? That if there is a lot of hair accumulated in there, you see it? When it gets in there, all the hair is in there. In the infomercial, they said this little thing collects the hairs. Yeah, no. The static from the hair is actually attaching the hair to the inside little padding thing. This thing is not collecting any hair.
Regular lint brushes are hard to clean, but with just a dip, Fur Wizard cleans up quick.
So to clean it, pull out your vacuum. No. No, 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 no. This is too much work. Just get one of these for like a dollar at Target and just fucking pull the roller out. This is not gonna work. It picks up hair, but it's more trouble than it's worth. It's not as easy as just pulling this little bottom piece off like they did in the infomercial. This whole bottom piece and the hair collecting at the bottom part of that little padding in there just completely killed it for me. Too much work. Pain in the ass. Extra shit for me to do. No thank you. So for all of those reasons, I'm gonna give the Fur Wizard 1 Vivian head. All right, you guys, so that is it for another Vivian Tries. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. If you have, don't forget to give it a big fat thumbs up for me in the comments down below. Let me know if you've seen a cool as seen on television product that you think I should try and it might get featured in an upcoming episode. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. I am putting out 1 to 2 videos every week for your entertainment. Don't forget to share the video with your family and your friends, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!